Hey friends, it's Robin Graham here, and I am jumping onto video today because I want to give you guys some tips on lighting. I see this so often where people are doing selfies for their business or they are doing a video for their business and they are poorly lit. So I want to give you a couple of tips that will help you make better videos, take better pictures that will help your audience be able to see you in the light that you want them to see you in. That's kind of a play on words. But anyway, I want to teach you just a couple of tricks that will make a big difference, because when you're doing video or taking pictures, but we're gonna focus primarily on video today, okay? But it's really the same premise for both selfies as well as video. But when you are doing video, it is so important to be well lit, because your connection to your ideal audience is going to happen mostly through your eyes and through your smile. So we want you to be well lit so people can really easily see you. You don't want people to be looking at your video or looking at your images and thinking, gosh, I can barely see her. It's so dark. Oh, she's underexposed. I wonder if her content's as good as the picture, because if it is, then it might not be worth listening to, so on and so forth. So what I want you to do is always be well lit, whether it is a still photography image or whether it is a video. So a couple of hints. One, you can use natural light. You don't even have to have an external light source or anything other than a window or a door if that's all you have and you don't want to invest in other lighting equipment. But if you're going to be using natural light and you're going to be using a window, you need to be facing that window, because if your back is to the window, your recording device, most likely your camera, your iPad, your computer, it's going to read the light as an average around you. And it's going to see all that light behind you and think that you are well lit, just like that light coming from behind you. And that won't be the case. You will end up underexposed. I see this happening all the time. People think they have a great light because they have a window, but their back is to the window. So they are actually underexposed. It's something that, of course, as a photographer, you know, light is my life, and it really, I find it really frustrating, but it is super, super important. If you have a window, but you don't have the option to be facing the window, you can use the window as backlighting, but you need to make sure 100% that you are also lighting the front of you. You can find tools like ring lights. You can find lights with an umbrella on a stand on Amazon really inexpensively. They aren't great lights. They're not what a professional photographer would use in a studio for studio lighting, but they're lights that will provide continuous light to light you while you're doing your video or taking a selfie. So it's something to think about investing in if you're going to be doing a lot of videos, which I would encourage, just because that is the wave of the future. We're going to start seeing more and more video content as this year, you know, folds into 2020 and so on and so forth. So keep that in mind, that it may be a good investment, because if you're not well lit, people are not going to give you the credibility that you deserve for the content that you're putting out, because it shows that either, you know, you don't really care about the quality or you're not as professional. But just being poorly lit will turn people away. So you want to be really well lit. Another thing you can do is, if you don't want to invest in those, if you have a lamp, just buy a white light bulb. You don't want a tungsten light that is going to be too yellow and make you look jaundiced. You also don't want a fluorescent light that's going to make you look purple or blue, because then you'll appear cold and standoffish. So it does get kind of tricky. I have an ebook available. You can go to the link in my bio, and it is all about doing smartphone photography for business. And in that ebook is a whole section on lighting. So you can identify some tools there that I have used myself and things that I recommend, but you can also get more detail. But for the purpose of this video, I just want to make sure that you understand how important it is to be well lit, because it really is going to make a difference in the emotional connection that you make with your audience when you're doing video content. The same thing for selfie. photography. If you're doing selfies, you want to make sure that you are indeed well lit. You don't want to be backlit unless you have another light source lighting your face. If you don't have a window and you just strictly have ambient light from, you know, the ceiling light or a lamp or something else, you want to make sure that you are lit on multiple sides so that you're not shadowing one side of your face but not the other side of your face. That can be very artistic when we're doing intentional portraits that way for Rembrandt lighting, but it's not as good whenever you're trying to do a video and make a good impression. So just make sure that whatever light source you're using, the light is coming at you from different angles, different ways, so that you are well lit and people can really see your eyes and be able to engage with your eyes and your smile, because that is going to be the connection into the other people's souls and hearts, so that you can make that connection and then grow on that and have engagement from that. So I hope this answered any of your questions regarding lighting. If you want to know the one light that I use all the time, it is window light in addition to an ice light. I love my ice light. So if you are interested in that, they're available on Amazon and B&H Photography and probably a lot of other resource sites as well. Any photography, big photography or video store. But you can put them on a tripod. They're an excellent source of continuous light. They are a little more expensive than, say, a ring light, but they provide great light and they're very easy to use. Lastly, I want to just give you one more tip. If you have eyeglasses, you really, really have to be careful with the reflection and the glare in the glasses. So a couple of tips that you can use is always look at yourself in the camera before you start a video to make sure that you don't have a lot of glare. You don't want the glare to cover your eyeballs. You can keep your chin down just a little bit so that the light comes to the rim of the glasses. You can tilt the glasses up just a little bit, and that too will help the light stay towards the rim of the glasses versus on the eyeballs. But make sure that you put forth that effort to avoid the glare or the reflections in the glasses, because you don't want to hide your eyeballs. You want people to be able to see your eyes and make that emotional connection with you. Okay, that's a wrap. That's the end of my tips for today, but if you have any questions, just let me know. Thanks so much and have a great afternoon.